Well, the Parish Council Monday night extended the moratorium south of I-12 on new subdivisions. One of those on hand, of course, was Carlo Bruno, the outgoing chairman. And why do this for the third time? Is there that much still to work out on subdivision regulations?
Well, Ken, the committee, and I do sit on the committee is very, very close now. We're probably within the next 2 weeks to be finalizing all of the details of the new rules. And we're hoping by the 31st of January that it will be on the agenda for the Parish Council to review and set the public hearing and to vote on it in a couple of weeks. So we're very, very close. And, you know, even the home builders told us, you know, not to rush it, to make sure we got it right. And they've been a part of the whole process. They've been sitting in with us. And I think we're going to wind up with a pretty good document once it's completed.
Any chance that out of this we'll give a break to some of our local builders? Nothing against the big companies that have moved in, but is there anything we can do to help the little guy?
Well, that's one of the things we're wrestling with now, is how we can protect the little builder on these little small plots of land, because, you know, they already struggling. Most of your builders in the parish now have went to custom homes because it's just too much for them to develop little small subdivision. And the big ones like DSLD and Horton and all of them have pretty much cornered that market. So that's one of the things that we're batting back and forth to try to get some solution. But yes, we're trying to do something to protect our local builders that are just building individual houses.
How about on the drainage front? Do you think it'll make a difference in some of those areas like Bedico that are so low-lying?
It's definitely going to make a difference. Now, you know, the one thing that I've pointed out in the past and I want to point out again, this is not going to stop the developments that have already been built.
Those that are permitted already.
That's correct. Those developments are already either built or permitted. And, you know, the outcome that you have there is going to be the outcome that you have. But one thing good, if there's any more developments that's going to go around these that are already there, the regulations are definitely going to make a difference. It's going to decide about how many trees that can be taken out of a plot of land, no more clear cutting, you know, no more adding a lot of dirt to the lots. It's going to be more of a footprint type of situation, to where you'll be able to bring in dirt for where the house is going to sit, but the rest of the area will stay intact. So those kind of things are going to help tremendously with the drainage.
Will these new restrictions apply parish-wide or just south of I-12 or just east of the river? Has that been discussed?
Well, that's another thing that we're batting around, because, as you know, the topography in the parish is a lot different when you get Natal Benny North. And, you know, this was made for where there's mostly areas where it's very flat and the drainage is bad. So that has not been decided yet. That's going to have to be talked about. But those are the kind of things we're at that point now, that once we can settle these issues, then we should be ready to vote on this pretty shortly.
There's been talk over the years about incentivizing some areas that could use some more home building, like, for example, Independence. And let me say, that's also part of your district. The new mayor, Jim Payne, he's doing a yeoman's job of encouraging new home building in Independence. They've got a couple of subdivisions coming online. But you know what I'm talking about, the U.S. 51 corridor.
Well, you know, Ken, home building is kind of followed by the pattern of where people want to live, you know. And for years, Independence had a bad rap. And, you know, it just shows you, just in a few months, what can happen when you start cleaning up and you start painting the buildings and you see some businesses coming into the town. You know, I talked to the mayor about a week ago, and, you know, his tax rate was up, his tax collections were up. So that means people are starting to shop, and we still have a couple of new businesses that haven't opened. The Wings place is almost ready to open. There's a couple of new clinics that's going to open up. Those people are buying things. So I think there's a bright future for Independence, and, you know, my hat's off to Jim and that council. They're working very hard to bring that little town back.
And plus, it's high ground.
That's right. And, you know, I think what success brings people in. So hopefully, you know, I'd like to see that become a retirement area. You know, people retiring up north, it's the perfect place. There's a hospital, there's supermarkets, there's drug stores, there's cheap lots that can be bought, there's houses that can be redone. So I'd like to see them incentivize it and try to get some of that snowbird traffic to come to Independence.
What else are you working on?
Well, it's that time of year, Ken. You know, we get into the holidays. It's been a really tough year. You know, we've been lucky here at Parish Government. The people still have been buying at home. And our, as you heard tonight, our sales tax is doing great. The people re-voted for our sales tax. We have a lot of things going on. We've got a lot to be thankful for. And hopefully this new year with the vaccine and all that, hopefully we'll get back to some sort of normal if we ever get back to what we call normal. But I just want to wish everybody a happy, a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. And please, by all means, stay safe.
So, you know, if you're not grateful to live in Tangipahoa, oh, compare what we're going through now to New York City or Los Angeles. But even closer than that, look at how the New Orleans economy has been decimated compared to ours. Restaurants here have had to make some adjustments, but it's nothing like the pain you've seen in some other areas.
Well, you know, I saw a graphic last night on the news. They took the surrounding parishes and they showed the sales taxes since the pandemic. And you know, St. Tammany was up 28% by the month. We were up 24. I think Jefferson was up 16, and New Orleans Parish was down 63%. So, you know, it's been devastating down there, what they've done to the businesses. And, you know, I see their rate of infection not any much better than ours. So I don't think the lockdown is the way to do it, but I mean, that was the path they chose, and you see what it's done. It's destroyed a lot of businesses that I don't think is ever going to come back.
But we're seeing New Orleans businesses relocate to Tangipahoa, in some cases without fanfare. In my little subdivision, we've got six or seven families from the South Shore.
Yeah, and you know, we fail to mention, you know, Medline got passed through the city of Hammond last week, and you know, we're looking at a situation where a company is going to come in. It's going to need trucking. It's going to need logistics people and things like that. So, you know, one business spawns off another one. So those are good things. And, you know, hopefully this year is going to be a lot better.
Injuries can occur anytime, any place, and it may not be your fault. I'm attorney Sherman Madden, and it's my duty to make sure you get the legal representation that you deserve. At the Mack Law Firm, we represent you and your family, and we'll make sure your legal needs are met. Contact us at tangilawteam.com. Our team is ready to help.